Okay, so a couple of videos might be a little bit complicated, but what we're basically doing is looking at energy to enhance health and martial arts. So, six element qigong, call it what you will, six elements rather than five gets energy in the meridians in the right sequence. So it negates the yin yang effect, shorting out left right, top and bottom, which makes you weak, it now makes you stronger. It negates body misalignment, so if you've got a dodgy stance or you're looking the other way, that'll make you weaker, now it makes you stronger. It stops organ disruption, meridian disruption, and loads of other stuff, increases static strength and all the rest of it. Resistance to joint locks, pressure point strikes. What I wanted to do was crack the destructive cycle. So I'm shorting out meridians, pressure points, making a fist. So rather than that being detrimental and lighting up the fire and metal meridians, at least now it's actually producing energy, positive energy, enough to disrupt somebody that is energized anyway. So you'll see that in the videos. So maybe now we're even more resistant to pressure points and joint locks, and they should now make you stronger, and you not just resistant to them, they'll actually increase your strength. So if somebody hits me on a pressure point, I'll get a charge and I can react to it, probably. Thank you very much. Okay, this is Young Ruth. We're looking at disruption. Now we've got to start off at a basic level, because Ruth ain't got no energy, because we ain't done no forms and no Qigong sets yet. But when we've done them, not only will your fist disrupt somebody's energy, but it will give you resistance to the disruption. So you've got to get one person at one level before you try and test, else it's going to mess up. So I've got loads of energy, so what we can do is either kinesiology or smack them in the abs, which is a form of kinesiology, because if those abs are weak, you will go, ugh. And the way to test it on a big fella that ain't believing in any of this is to smack him with a neutral fist, and they'll go, nothing. Then you do the disruption, and he will move. And probably deny everything, but he'll move. So safety is no stance, so he can move. So, two normal karate people, kinesiology, strong, drop down there, this goes weak, okay? Or, punch him in the abs, strong, drop that, punch him, and they'll move back. And it's said to go in. Now I want to go up a level, so we're going to do the forms, we're going to do the Qigong exercises, and then we're going to see if I got another level of disruption. We've already got one level, which is this, but we want to see if it still works when Ruth's charged up, because it shouldn't, but I'm thinking it will, because we've got a new set of exercises. So did you get all that? You can try it at home. Thank you very much. Banzai! So that's probably better if we had three people with somebody that hadn't done anything. So now we've done form one, chuk form one, staff form one, yin yang qigong to fill meridians with energy to stop organ disruption, yin yang effect, body misalignment, meridian disruption, you name it, lots of stuff. So now if I do that, it shouldn't. So we'll try it. I'll do that one. Excellent. I reckon it makes you stronger. Shorting out left right, that makes you stronger rather than weaker, etc. We've done it before in other videos, so that works. So now, if I make a fist, it shouldn't disrupt. But the next level is sorting out the destructive cycle. So we're shorting out meridians, pressure points. So we're lighting this up. The more energy we've got in the meridians, the more energy is in that fist. So this now is not only equivalent to an empty open hand, but it's better. I think. I've tried this before. Only Dale's did. So, haha! We're gonna strike this. Fist. Boom! Marvellous. So, it's upper level. Excellent. So, one way of doing it is make a fist and drop it so it's the same motion as doing an open hand. But if we see, open hand doesn't do anything. So now making a fist has gone from neutralizing it through the yin yang effect, lighting up the fire and metal meridians, and really putting you at an energetic disadvantage. Obviously, if you train like a lunatic and you're really hard, it don't matter that much, but any advantage is a positive advantage. So now disruption has gone up a level. So I don't know how much it's going to hurt Steve on Monday.
Poor Steve.
Poor old Steve.
Okay, so we want to recheck this new disruption because young Ruth here has done the postures in a new way that makes them more efficient. So maybe, don't know, give us an arm there, Ruth, a bit nice and strong. So, the new disrupted punch. Boom! No, I'm still good. What, do it again? Do it again.
Do them again.
Do them again.
Okay, last video, disruption was still effective, but I did the postures with Ruth, so I went up a level as well. So this time, I buggered off outside. Ruth did the postures in a new way, and now we think we're at the same level. The dowsing says we are, so maybe... Boom! Bloody hell! Marvellous! Hey! Eh? Oh! Eye! Protection and offence!
Brilliant!